Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. I welcome you back again to tonight's talk. And I am so grateful to you all for being here. Now we'll talk on some fundamental of life. What is life? So life is nothing but happenings, just very clearly. Everything is happening, and that is happening to Allah's will. We accept that. Even we say that even a leaf does not fall without Allah's will. So external life as a human being is happenings. Now the human beings is the only species, they say, they see through interpretations, interpret nothing but the perceptions. Perception is whatever a human being sees, he adds meaning and sees through the meaning. He does not see reality. So now this is the meaning we see through. So then we ask ourselves, are we human beings or are we meaning-making machines? So let's go back to the fundamentals. Is we are God created as human beings. But we fall down to the lowest of the low and we become machines. And we see everything and respond to based on the interpretations and the meanings that we take. So, as a human being, God created us. We have to go back to see that we have been created and we have two forces. One is the Qarin, the evil inside us. It is a part of system. And there is also the angelic force, or also the spirit of Allah inside us. So there is a good force inside me, there is an evil force inside me. So a human being has got two forces internally. This is the base. Now, whatever happens in the external, we perceive, make a meaning out of it. And most of us, what kind of meanings we take? Now we have many superstitions. We can say, if the hand is scratching, we say the money is coming. If I'm going out on a good work, if a cat is crossing, we say the bad omen, we take money. If a ladder is there, under that I go, there's a bad omen. So there are hundreds of superstitions of meanings we have in every culture, every society, every nation has got it. It's full of that. And our response and action is based on the meaning that I give. Now, what is happening is the reality, the fact, the truth, the reality. And whatever happens, I make a meaning. This is what the base. Now, most of the time, we can see in our families, in issues, you go in everyone, they take a negative meaning. And that negative meaning, how does it come? So what we say is go back. We say that external is a function of who I am inside. This is the base. Who I am inside depends on whom I am connected to inside. Either I am connected to the evil here or the good here. So when something does not happen my way, is not okay what happened, so I connect to the evil inside and I take the evil meaning, negative meaning. So I, this mind is a tool that I possess. Now when I connect to the evil inside, the evil takes over my sense and the mind. And when the mind takes over by the evil, what I see, I say, all that becomes the evil. So the whole society is full of meanings. And those meanings are causing the suffering, not actually what's happening. So if you are able to distinguish this very clearly, you will be out of the sufferings of all the problems in the world. The suffering is not on the reality. Allah says, all the good is from me. What happens? There is no suffering. And the suffering exists only in the interpretation that I make. Now, that interpretation causes this suffering. If your mother says something, why have you come late from the college or school? And the moment you enter, she's asking, where have you been? Then suddenly you take a negative meaning. When the husband comes home late and says, is this the time to come? Suddenly what happens to you? You take a meaning. Suddenly somebody comes and bangs at you. What happens? Somebody does not make salam to you. What happens? If your son does not wake up, what happens? If you find your son has failed in the exam, what happens? If someone did not invite you, what happens? So every moment, the whole society we are living inside is full of meanings and meanings and meanings. And most of the meanings that we are taking out, is it good or evil? I'm not saying not to take meanings out of us. Even if you can take meaning, take a good meaning inside. That's why Allah Ta'ala says also in the Quran that what you think is good may be bad for you. What may be bad for you may be good for me. In any situation, when you connect to good inside, connect to Allah inside, connect to spirit of angel, what will happen is you see good. When you see good and you take good meaning inside, whatever happens, good will happen. But most of us are connected to the evil. That's why Allah says, most of us have taken the evil as their wali, as their protector. So when inside, if my evil is my friend and muhafiz or a protector, then what happens is my perception, my seeing, in everything that I see evil. Even if you visit your sister's house, suppose, she says, now he has come with something, matlab se aaya hai, and again with some intention he might have come. He has just come to see the brother or sister, how are you? But he says without that meaning. So you look into your life, just go analyze yourself, sit down for 5 minutes and see what are the meanings that you are taking for everything someone says to you. When your father says something to you, when your husband says something to you, when your wife says something to you, if someone says something to you, you look inside and see what meaning I am taking. Is it the evil meaning or the bad meaning or the good meaning? And who is responsible for taking that meaning? You are responsible for the meaning. He said what he said, but you took a negative meaning. Then when you took a negative meaning, an evil meaning, a bad meaning, who is responsible? You or he? You. I know that. Whatever the way he said it, the way your mother-in-law said to you, the way she is fighting with you, yes, she said whatever she said. But out of that, what meaning did you take? Just if you are really present to that consciously, to every meaning that you take, and you are aware of the meaning that you take, and if you are aware that, yes, this meaning I took, and because that evil meaning I took, I am experiencing irritation, I am experiencing anger, I am experiencing this upset, not what your mother-in-law said. Not that your daughter-in-law did not ask you and went to her mother's house, did not upset you, got irritated. For you it is not okay. She should have asked me and taken permission and gone to her mother's house. She did not ask me. How daring she can do that? And you go into that spin and anger and upset because for you it is not okay. And everything that she should be, my way she should follow. And when you are such independent, evil is my way, is the I way, I, me, mine. And all this negativity is because of the meanings that I take. And you suffer because of that. And when you are always 24/7 in your mind for everything that is happening outside, you are constantly thinking of negativity, 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 what is happening, it has a great impact on your body. This adrenaline balance happens. So now slowly you will develop blood pressure, sugar, diabetes, cancer. 80% of the diseases is because of the psychosomatic. You are responsible for creating that disease. Stop it. Allah has given us a way of life. Allah, all the good is from me. And anything that happens, take a good meaning out of it. Even if you have been, suppose, say, terminated from the job, inside that also you think there may be something good inside that. And when you always think good, good will come. Okay, one choice is that either you take negative meaning or positive meaning. Another way of living is, third way of a higher up level, a way of living is, this has happened, happened. Neither I'm taking a good meaning, nor the negative meaning. Nor I'm saying anything. Just I say, I look for solutions. It's happened. What is the solution? Everything happens to Allah's will. I surrender, I accept, I submit to whatever happened, and I take an action. So you have a choice now to live a life of peace, happiness, joy. Allah does not love sufferings. He does not want to see your face. So you are responsible. I am responsible. And everyone is responsible for the meanings I take. Change the meanings in your mind, your life changes. Always think good. That's why Allah says, bring a good thought in your mind, there is a one reward. And if you act on the good thought, you will be given 10 rewards. So Allah wants you to think good and act good. As a Muslim, as a mu'min, I'm always thinks of good. Never again that the shaitan, the evil that always puts you fear inside you. And that fear of external loss, position, people, material, and he puts the fear of the people in your heart. And when you are engrossed into the people, fear of the external, losing the job, losing the money, losing the position, losing all that, when the fear of the people comes in your heart, the fear of Allah disappears from you. Have tawakkallah, trust Allah. Whatever in the future, because suffering is all anxiety, what will happen, all the meaning is there. So trust Allah. Future is tawakkallah. Whatever happened in the past, say, that is my destiny. It has happened, happened. Submit it, accept it. Don't go on to the record of it should not have happened, it should not have happened. Why it happened? I might have committed a sin. That's why Allah is punishing me. Allah is not there to punish you. Allah does not want to. Allah loves you. You are punishing yourself. You are doing zulm to your own nafs. Stop that. Now, choose a life of quality life. Quality life depends on the meaning that you give to everything that is happening. If you start taking everything that is happening in your life, if you take a good meaning, you will experience goodness and you will be focused and there will be solution. Then take actions. If your evil meaning you take negative and you put a filter in your eyes, and all the actions will be failures. So my job is now to remove the veils from yourselves. See the truth. This has happened. That is Allah's will. I surrender. I accept what happened. Now I have only the choice to respond to what happened. And whatever I choose by response, I am responsible for it. And I'm accountable for the responsible account of it. I'm not responsible for what's happening outside there. So living a responsible life, a life of quality, depends on the meanings that I give to life. And I stop giving meanings to that. I live a life of reality and submit. I am a human being. So being human, so Jazakallah khair, thank you very much.